Okay guys, welcome back to the channel. This is tutorial series number 39 here in Maharlikan's Code. Okay, so we are about to continue guys this password reset. So watch until the end of this video guys, because we have successfully done this password reset functionality of our Yabby authentication system here. So this would be so stay tuned for that. And then those people who want to be honored here in Maharlikan's Code, just comment down below with your nice comment guys, so that we'll be reading it. We'll be reading your very nice comment at the very end of our video. Okay, so to honor you guys here in Maharlikan's Code. Okay, and then after this, stay tuned for our last discussion for this Yabby series. Probably this is after this password reset, which is the outside of this user's authentication. I mean, those users totally forgot the password. That's why we provide this functionality, which is the users. This password reset. But those user that successfully log in from their dashboard. Then we provide the change password there. So that would be probably our last section or last part of this Yabby series. But of course, we are open, of course, guys, so to enhance this authentication, the Yabby authentication system here. So we will be adding more features. And then I need help of you guys there to test this Yabby authentication system. But the end goal of this authentication system is we can publish this into our IT Republic GitHub, so that you guys out there, when you have a web project that in Golang, of course, it requires authentication system, probably you can use this freely guys in our here in Maharlikan's Code. Of course, don't forget the Maharlikan's Code guys. Okay, thank you so much for watching my tutorial series here. And then let's dive into this tutorial guys. Okay guys, welcome back to the channel. Okay, this one we need to continue about these things guys. So we need to add this thing to capture our time. I added this password reset complete. This one is just a static page then, so that we can inform the user that the password reset process or the new password has been changed successfully, so that we can just redirect static page. Okay guys, and then after this I added here is just a plain static one. So we have a numerous times that we have done this, so I assume that you master all these things. Okay guys, so it just completely changed all this HTML page and the page title and whatsoever there. And then after this is I added also this one under the front HTML here, the new static HTML, which is the password underscore reset underscore complete HTML. So just adding the standard one guys. Okay, and then we need to test this if this page really can display properly or not before we can do proceed with the other things. Okay, go run main.go now, and then we will test this new page here. This one we never add one guys. Okay, so this is the password reset complete page. It's like a man with a rocket behind this one. So successfully reset, so you can just log in with this from this page guys. So okay, so we will be continuing this, and then we will expect to display this one after we have done changing our new password. Okay, so we will we will continue on, and then we will be adding a few things here. So we will be adding a new thing here guys. So probably this is for our password reset. So I just added this to capture our time. So we are about to add this password reset now. This this one is having a token here, which is our parameter, same with our activate new users activation guys. So this one is a password reset. So the moment that when the users receive the email there, so we can just click this and then continue on. Then we will go to the password reset there, which is the new page. Okay, we will be adding this, and then we will go go down a little bit, guys. Okay guys, to catch our time again, guys, so I don't want to waste too much of our time here, because in this case, guys, this one is, I added this password reset. Now this is the actual page that the moment that when we receive this kind of email. In our previous discussion, we have done this. We received this kind of email regarding the password reset. Okay, once the user click this button here, the reset your password. Okay, then once they click this link, then automatically we will be redirecting to that the new page there, which requires the user to enter the new password and of course the new password, but we don't require the older password, so we don't want to stress too much our users. Okay, so this one we will this what we are going to do now is this page up upon the user clicking this button here, then it will redirect to the new page, guys. Okay, so we will be adding this, and then this one we have done on the top here, so we added this along with the token parameter here. Okay, so this one, and then I added this password reset now as well, which is this one. So in this case, I added this hidden field, hidden input field, which is the PW token. So actually this is the token that is a random token, guys, that we need to embed on that page there. Then later on, once the user user will submit that new password, then after that we will embed this, and then we need to get this password token here. This one is a publicly known information along with the URL there. So okay, so this one is a quite standard one, guys. We need to get the parameters here, as you know it in our previous discussions many times. Okay, this one also we need to decode that payload here, which is the token. We have our Timahan package as well here, which is our famous Timahan package, which is our very own. This one is a very useful when you want to use those kind of authentication, guys. So okay, this is a good thing if you have the GitHub packages there, that we can just easily use our packages. Okay, and then after this we need to decode. We all know all these things, guys, in our discussions here in the Martkens code. And then after this, if this email address, because we are now getting only the email address. Why the email address? Because this one is a unique one as well, along with the username and the email address. This one is all unique to our records, guys, in our table there, the Yabby underscore user table. Okay, so the one we can use directly the email there, okay, because this one serves as a unique as well. So if this one is missing along with the payload there, and then we just want to throw the page not found, which is our customized page not found here. Okay, so we just want to display that 404 page, our own customized page. And then after that, of course, we need to check whether the token there is already expired or not. So we need to double check this one first. This is one of the indicator here, our parameters or arguments and criterias prior to change or display that change password. Okay, so this one is the main thing, guys, so don't forget about this one. And then page not found. Okay, and then after this is the standard one as well, which is our own MySQL what they call this package here, the function. Okay, and then we just want, after that all okay, then we just straightforward display this. This one we no longer need hold on, guys, so we don't need this anymore here, so we don't want this MySQL as well. So this one is okay, so we just want to display this one. We need to check. Okay, so need to run a little bit, this one need to test prior to display this thing, guys. So now we need to request, we need to receive a new email here, guys. Okay, we need to go to the password reset, which is, this is the thing we are going to do, guys. This one is a forgot password when the user click this. And then, of course, we need to throw the correct email address. So we don't. This one we have tested in our previous discussion. So you know, no need for us to double check again, guys. Okay. Password reset sent. So we are expecting this. And then we receive a new email here, which is the password reset request. Just ignore this one, guys. Okay. So now we have the password reset. So I need to click this. We have done this page, so this is the password reset now. So okay, when the moment when I click this, guys, and then we'll check if it's the new page is working or not. Okay, click, and then it loaded. Okay, now it's working fine, guys. We can see that this is the look and feel or the UI design. It's just a decent design, guys, so that there is a password and a confirmed password only. So remember that we don't want to require much of the old password unless you are unless you want to very strict, guys, about that user's re-authentication. But in this case, this is a password reset, so probably the user might not be remember the older password. Okay, but in the future we will enhance this. Okay, so but this one is a decent enough for our security things. Okay, so that because this one is the only the users can receive this email address, because the user itself can access the email. So probably this one is a only the users can only that user, particular user that owns this, for example, this username, this what they call this email address, can receive this email password reset link here. So this one is exclusive, unique, or whatsoever that one, guys. Okay, so right now we need to this is the new page, and then this is actually the random what they call this Google UUID. So this is the UUID what they call this library itself by provided by Golang. So okay, so we use this to reset the password. Okay, in this case we need to create this change password here in our WebAssembly. Okay, so that we will create that, and then after that we need to create a new URL router the moment the user click this change password. Okay, so we will dive into this again, guys, into this tutorial, and then okay, embed this URL router there. Okay, so again I need to go to this page. So again, guys, I just want to, because we don't want to again to rewrite everything here, so we just want to copy this and then change the URL router, because this one is all quite standard one. So this one all the standard headers here, and then the IO util for our to read our the body of this endpoint here. Okay, so and then we need to get those parameters that will be thrown to this URL route, guys. The moment that the change password button there will be clicked by the user. Okay, so remember also that we embed this password. We call it PW token. This is what we call the password. This is a password token, guys. That this one, this indicates this URL router. This is the unique token here that will be provided by the what they call this Google UUID. Okay, so this one, and then of course the new password, and then the confirmed password for the user. Okay, this one again, this is to decode using our Timaan, our own package called the Timaan token, to decode the payload here from this PW token here. This is the PW token, guys, and then we need to decode this. Remember that we stored this in our map, and then this one also we stored automatically in our table here called the Yabi underscore user underscore token. So we just want to refresh. Okay, the moment that the user requests for the password reset, So there is an indicator here as well, token source. Last time we have this auth as a source when the user tries to log in using this their own account. At this time, we added a new feature here, which what we call the token source, which is the password reset. So again, this token here is embedded with what you call this GoPin code. So this one is a byte, guys. So we cannot read easily this one. And then of course there is a expire on. This is our standard persisted token, so we need to keep those token as well. Remember that when we do this, we need to restore back this token the moment that we restarted our web server. So at this point, when this server restarted, so we automatically restore back only those not expired one. And then remember that we have a goroutines that we're always constantly running along with the web server there to check all those expired one, then automatically clean up all those these tokens here that all expired, and then of course those in the in our own map as well. So we stored two things there, so which is the memory stored in the Timaan token as well, and then of course here in as our token storage. Okay, so just a quick overview, guys, because this quite long. This is the quite long discussion regarding this authentication system, because this one is a more complicated system. So we need to ensure that the moment that we use this in our Golang project, at least we have a decent enough security and functionalities of our authentication system. So at least when we do our Golang project next time, when we have a web project there that requires username and the password and then the authentication system, so at least we have these solutions that will be provided by here in Maharlikan's code. And then of course don't forget Maharlikan's code, guys. Okay, later on, remember again that this one will be published on our GitHub to finalize things. We are almost done with this one, guys. This one will be the password reset. This is the second to the last. And then probably we go back to the dashboard again to change the password there. So that one will be a quicker one. That one is when the user successfully log into the dashboard there and then tries to reset the password there again. So we need to, that one is in a page level, so at least we can do something that is, that one is a quite fast one, guys. So we can just and then after that we finalize things and then probably publish this on our IT Republic GitHub there. Then we can try to go get this one. So I will let you know once this package has been is ready, guys, for our production things there. But of course I need your help, guys, out there to test further of our web of this what you call the Yabi authentication use authentication system, so that you guys out there, we can finalize things, and then we will be publishing this in our GitHub, so that we can just plug and play into our Golang projects. That most of the Golang projects requires, of course, or any kind of a web development there requires, of course, the user's authentication system. So probably we will be enhancing this in the future, of course, so that we can strengthen this what they call this package here, the Yabi package, and then after that we will be happily use this. Okay, so again this one is stored. Okay, so we just want to test again. So this one, guys, I stopped the server here, the web server, so probably we can restore back again this token there. So here, still there. Okay, because it's not yet expired. spike. Okay, so when we refresh this URL, so it's not showing the page not found, which is the 404. Okay, so this one, this is the thing, guys. So we just want to confirm again. Okay, it's good. The moment that we restart, or and unexpectedly that we restarted our server, our web server for this Golang, we will restore back. So we don't want the we don't want to have a bad user's experience from when we develop a web a website or any kinds of a platform out there. So we don't want to have that kind of experience, the user's experience there is not restored properly, all those tokens there. So it's to remove those hassle from the user side. Okay, so after this, now is we restored back. We continue on, guys. Okay, so we require only this new password and the token, the password token here. So when we right click this one, so again, guys, this is a WebAssembly. So just a quick reminder that WebAssembly is the future of web development here as of this recording. Okay, so you need to look for the password, the PW token here, which is this one. So exactly the same 842, at least at the the third value here, at least. Okay, 842. So correct, guys. So probably you can just search as well. So the exact strings here is the exact thing, and this is the hidden value. So at least we can get this one, guys, the moment that the user click these buttons here. Okay, this change password button. So we also embed that, and then we also captured it. Okay, then after that, this one is the password token. So we need to decode from our Timaan token here. So decode payload. So the moment that we use this decode payload, then we can extract back those payload, guys. Remember that the payload there only contains this email address from this user. So we need to capture only this string value here, which is the field value, contains the exact email string. Okay, and then after that, we already captured the email address there, which is the embedded one. And then of course we need to we password reset new password here, so we can I added this as well, our new feature there in our Yabby package. Okay, so this one, we will go to this definition here. So I also added this one. It's also quite standard one, guys, so we don't want to repeat again ourselves. So I just want to explain so that we will be more a little bit faster here. Okay, so again, we require the SQL there, the email address, and the new password, confirm password, and then the token, and then of course your secret key. Okay, check if email address. Again, this one is a standard validation here, guys, so you don't want to explain further on that one. And then this one is a check if confirm password is empty. This one also quite standard one, just an empty string. And then of course this one is a new and confirmed password. Ensure that this one, those password, guys, must be matched. Okay, this also is a quite standard one. It's a basic one. And then of course this one now change the password. This is the this would be interacting with our MySQL table there. So this what do you call this one? The Yabby underscore user table. So this is our master users list. Probably we will change this password, and then we need to encrypt and then decrypt again. This one is a standard encryption of Go, so we don't want to bother much on this. Then so this one is a update user's password. Just want to continue on, guys. So until this one is, we need to delete the token. So after that, later on we will discuss that. So we will go to this update user password here. Which is also I added this one. So this one is also standard for our coding here, to just to update any kind of a table there, a row, or something like this, guys. So we just want to change the password there, but of course we just want to ask for the plain text password, because this one we need to hash and solve this one. So this is also our package here, we call it Sakto. Okay, so this one we need, it requires a byte, and then of course this is the hash password. So we only stored the hash password. This, there's no other way, guys, that you can extract or decode this password to back back to this plain text password. This there is no way for this, because this one is just a one-way ticket going to somewhere else. Just kidding, guys. Okay, this plain password, so we require only, and then go the what I call this internal package of Go, which is the hash password here. So we don't want to worry much about this. So this is my package here, guys, called the Sakto. So I created a small wrapper here so that we can use it properly, and then we can reuse, we can reuse easily, guys. So we don't want to rewrite everything, this kind of code. So at least we can call this function is good enough, and then we use this bcrypt. This one is a bcrypt from Golang itself, so we don't want to trouble ourselves here in terms of security, guys. Okay so and then after this we need just change the password straight away, guys. But in our next future, probably in our future plans for Yavi authentication system, guys, we need to have some logs into our MySQL table there. Probably we can use a new table here so that we can store all those kinds of generic logs. So any kinds of log there, that like edit or something, or deleting some rows or soft delete, probably we can log as well. If this is one of the features there, so we can keep track the user's how they call this, the activity of the user. Okay, so probably we'll enhance, guys, so no worries. So we just want to update the password, and then of course match with the email address, and then if the user is active, okay, and then we just want to limit just in case. This one is just a safeguard, guys, that ensures that although our email is a unique one, but still we need to we just want to put a standard here, guys. More safeguard is better. So no harm in putting this one, or you can just remove, but this one is our package, so we can just use this in our package. So no worries about this one is just our safeguard thing. Okay, and then all the quite standard logging thing logs all these any kind of errors there. Okay, so that we will know as well, and then throw back to the user as well. Okay, we're going back again to this the main function, guys. This is the password reset new. This is the main function that we change the password that involves the users, this Yabi user table here. So actually this is the actual change password now, this main function here, which is what we call this password reset new password. We just want to standardize the name, guys, so that at the last part we just add the exact functionality. Okay, so update user password. Okay, then after this, if this one throw our function here requires or throws or return something like a boolean and error, so yeah, if this one is true, then we can proceed to this part. But otherwise it will be just throw back the error there, guys, if something wrong there. Okay, and then the tago encrypt, this is another function that the package that we are heavily used here in our web development series here in Harlequin's Code. Okay, so we need to decrypt back those token here.
and then encryption failed or whatever, guys. So we have done this numerous times, and then of course the UT removed those token here. This part will remove from our map table, guys, that's stored in our using this package Timaan. Okay, so we remove that in our memory as well, and then the second part is we need to delete to our table the YAV user token here. This part is very important as well, guys, because we don't want the user to reset the same thing here. For example, one scenario would be if the user tries to reset the password and then change it here, then successfully change those password, then after that the user go back to the email again and then click this link, then probably it can open back the same token here, which is the unique one by right. But we don't want that. We prevent that to happen, guys. So although it's possible, but it's not quite standard way of doing the password reset functionality, guys. So it means that what the user tries to use that URL again, that password reset, which is supposed to be the unique one, then after that it can reset the password again, because we never remove it into our Golang's map there, which is we stored it in our map, those token there, and then after that in our table here, which is this YAV user token here. So immediately when the user successfully reset the password, then we will automatically remove this user here, this token here, and then of course from our map. So the moment when the user tries to click again this reset your password, when the user visit the email, then we just want to ignore that, then we will throw the standard 404. Okay, so this part is we have done, guys. So no worries, we will publish again this into our Maharlikan's GitHub there, so you can grab all those codes, the latest source code. Okay, and then after this, this is our password reset new endpoint here. So probably it's a standard one. This one will throw a boolean one if it is true, successfully reset the password. Of course we need to redirect back to our static page, which is what we call the password reset complete. So we will throw this to this URL here, and then saying that the password successfully reset, so you can just you can log in now with your new password, something like that, guys. Okay, so after that we will create a new functions here that we need to expose back to the JavaScript side, because remember again that this is we are working on with a web assembly here. Okay, I highly recommend, guys, you learn this web assembly, because this is the future of the web development. We don't want to expose further URL routes like this instead of an AJAX post there. We don't want to expose much this information, okay? At least to hide the moment that when the user click this, for example, guys, because this is the web assembly, you cannot check any AJAX post here or the URL route. This is the beauty of this WASM, guys. They can only see this file from our static asset than JavaScript. This is this one is the auth.wasm. When the user tries to download this one, they cannot open this file anywhere or something like that there, because this one is a binary file that you cannot extract back or decode back all these things. Okay, so quick reminder again, guys. Okay, guys, to catch our time again, guys, I just want to add this new password here. We call it the new password for this function. This new password will be exposed to the JavaScript side there. We call this when the moment the user click this button, which is the change password there. So okay, this change password, then this function will be called. This one is a Golang function that we exposed there in the JavaScript side. Okay, for this WebAssembly. So this was so this one, guys, is a new password here. This one we just want to require those remember that those two input box there will be there. Okay, guys, this one is a quite standard one. So we only have confirm password and then the password and then confirm password. So we need to throw back to that one as one of the parameters there when the user click that change password. Okay, this one is our CSRF token here. Okay, we all know this one in our previous discussion. This one is our payload here, guys. So we only have three payload here, which is the password, confirm password, and the password token. Okay, after that, we need to do the marshalling here, the JSON marshal, and then of course we call this new API here, guys. This is a post API here again. This one is our password reset. The new password. Okay, and then we use the post method here, and then embed the CSRF token in our header part. And then after this, our standard code here, you can just copy this one, guys. So that I provided for you. And then after this is this this one is our standard way here, guys. Again, you know, here in Marnikan's code. So okay, then we replace and then we redirect back whatever the redirect URL here that will be passed on as the response, the JSON response back from our this one, guys. This what we call this password reset endpoint, and this is the JSON response data, or I mean the value, the result will be in the JSON format there. So after that, go back again to our WebAssembly here. This is a quite standard one. Then another one is we need to expose that one, guys. Slowly we need to scroll it. This one we need to copy one of this one, and then we need to expose that new password. Okay, this one is a new password. So this is our new function to be exposed. Okay, so we have done this, and then we are ready for the testing one. Before you do something, before we can compile this WebAssembly, guys, for our WASM authentication here, remember that we are using the Windows machine here, so we can use this to set the goose is equal to JS set go args in WASM in Ubuntu there. You can just straight away do this in one line of code, guys. So but in Windows we need to set it manually, split it into two commands that we need to execute. Okay, the set goose into JavaScript and then go args into WASM. Okay, guys, and then we can build now. Go build this argument here during the build. This one you can change the file name, guys. This is this purpose of this dash o is to change the outcome, or I mean the file name of that file. So hold on for a while, guys. Need to check that static one. We need to go to our static page here. Okay, this one. Okay, so I think I have here, so we can just open here. So this is our JavaScript side that we need to throw that WASM here, guys. So we need to copy this URL here. Okay, and then we paste it here, so we can now straightforward or directly we can throw that exported WASM here, which is to a specific location, so that we don't want to copy and then cut or transfer it, the file, to whatever you want to paste it there. So at the moment this is one in under the static and then the JavaScript side. So again we need to call it as old.wasm. Okay, and then the source here is of course the main.go. This main.go. Okay, press enter. If there is no error, then okay, guys. So, okay, so we can now check this one. So, today is 2 p.m. So, probably this one is okay. Now, we have a latest source code there for our the compiled authentication WASM there, the old.wasm. Okay, so we can run again. Go run that main.go. Let's see if we can successfully change that password, guys. Okay, so we can reset back again this one. So probably we can request a new application. Hold on, guys. So okay, so we will reset again. Okay, so probably this one just looks safe. Okay, reset password here. Let's see if just inspect a little bit, guys. I just want to check if any errors there. So the one says okay. Okay, so new password is not defined. Okay, probably need to refresh further. Okay, guys. Guys, just want to refresh the control F5 again, guys. Some caching there. Okay, this one okay, it's working now. Password in the basic. You need to check again, guys. The standard. Okay, our password with that. We just want to change the password to AAA. Just want to double check if confirm password. Okay, if the only one should not be matched. Okay, password not matched. Okay, I put the AAA here. Okay, let's see. Okay, so now automatically redirect to the password reset complete, guys. So probably we can try to log in now. Your password has been set. You may go ahead and log in with your new password. So we just want to click this one. Okay, Maharlikan. So my username here. We just want to double check this one should be removed, guys. So we just want to refresh. Okay, it's good, it's working. Okay, guys, just want to have some quick fix one. This one is should not be an encrypted password here, guys. So I mean the encrypted text. So we just want to use the plain one, which is the what they call that URL token there. So to remove that token, so just want to quick fix, not the encrypted value of this one, guys. So but in the MySQL table there, so we use the encrypted one. So okay, so we need to test further again, guys. So again, in the moment, so successfully removed from our MySQL table there, and then after this reset password, it should throw a 404. Okay, so it's working out, guys. Probably this is the thing now. We have done this tutorial series here, guys, here in this password reset. Okay, so we will try one more time. So we will do it again here, guys. So just one more time, guys. So just want to double check further. Okay, so go there and then check in our email here. So we will check. We will just about to receive this one. Okay, one round of testing, guys. Just want to check. Password reset now. Reset your password. Okay, so it will display. So we will change with the four A's, small A's. We will try change password. Okay, so this one also here is automatically removed, guys. We never load it first, but we have that in our previous discussion, so in our just a moment ago. Okay, and then after this, what we are expected, which is this static page, which is the password reset complete. Now we can go ahead and reset our password. But again, when the user click this reset password here, it should throw 404. Okay, so that we prevent the user to click that unique token there. So we just want to immediately expire it or rather remove it into our Timaan map there, which is the Goleng map, into our stored in our memory. And then after that is into our persistent token here in our MySQL table. Okay, so Here, this functionality is totally working, guys. Congratulations, you reached to this level. Just kidding, guys. Okay, okay, so the moment of truth now, we need to log in with the new password, guys. Okay, the Maharlikan's username. So if my previous password is a single 1A only, guys, so one letter A. So now it's failed. So that's second A, no, third. So now one I change with a new password, which is 4A, small letter A. Okay, guys, now we can log in back to our dashboard there. That means it's totally working, guys, our password reset functionalities. Okay, so I hope you enjoy the tutorial series here, guys, in Maharlikan's Code. So the next step would be probably our probably in this discussion is the last part of this our Yabi series, but still we're open for new features, guys, so stay tuned for that. This one is a change password now in our dashboard. So this is our last part, last section here, which is the change password inside this dashboard here. So which is the users successfully logged in, but of course we need to provide with this change password functionality inside the dashboard there, in the users dashboard. So this one we just want to display the single page here, which is again probably we require the old password, guys, and then after that we require the old password, and then of course the new password, and then the confirm password, because here he successfully, or she, or whatever the user, that the user successfully logged in. So probably the user still remember the password, of course we require, or accidentally when someone unwanted users use or forgot the the existing user forgot to log out or close the tab, and then of course we need to or accidentally still open there, then the user leave, of course we need the old password to be present there, to be one of the requirement when the user tries to remove or change the password. Okay, so that one is stay tuned for this tutorial, guys. This change password under the dashboard, that one is on the logout side. The password reset would be in the outside part, because the user cannot remember totally the password. So in this case, here is one of the featured security is we require the user to login, or provide the old password. Okay, so stay tuned for that, guys. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching here in Maharlikan's Code, and I hope you enjoy our tutorial series here, guys, here particularly here in Maharlikan's Code, which is the Yabi series. Okay, so we have successfully done this password reset, and then of course we have tested this, but of course we need your help, guys, to test this further, so that we will be strengthening up this package, so that you guys out there, we can reuse this every time we have a Golang web project that requires users authentication system. Of course we need to add this we will be adding more features to this. Just leave it down the comment down below, guys, so that we can discuss this, or probably in the comment section there, then we will be adding a new features this for this authentication system. Okay, so in our next discussion, guys, probably the change password inside those the dashboard there. So that one will be the quicker one. We just want to create a simple page out there inside the dashboard, and then of course require the old password, and then confirm password, and then the of course a password, and then confirm password, new password, confirm password. So this one will require the older password, so no choice. If the user wants to, this one is one of the security there for this Yabi authentication system. Okay, and then after this, right now is our shout out section for this video, guys. Okay, so we will check. This one is Papu Kumar. Okay, Papu Kumar, thank you so much for commenting out in my previous video, which is the how to set up the new domain name in Nginx. Okay, and then of course, Amer Hussein Jafari Barani. Thank you so much, Jafari, for commenting out, of course, in our previous discussion, which is the how to publish Golang package to GitHub. And then the last one, probably is Asep Jaipolo. Okay, thank you so much, Asep, for commenting out on my previous video also as well, called the how to unzip a zip file in Go. Okay, thank you so much, guys, for watching my tutorial series here in Maharlikan's Code. Please consider subscribing to my channel, guys, so that you can be notified every time we have a tutorial series here or a new video for our Golang discussion, and then you can press that notification bell as well. Thank you so much for supporting my channel, guys, and I see you in my next tutorial series here. And I hope you learn and enjoy watching here in Maharlikan's Code. Thank you so much for watching, and then may God bless us all. Thank you, and bye bye. Keep safe, everyone.